So Crimson Resort and Spa Boracay is an exclusive luxury tropical paradise. We are located at Station Zero, which is the end of the northern part of the island. Having 192 rooms, that's presidential villa, private villas with plunge pool, one bedroom suites, and deluxe rooms as well. We have three infinity pools and one kids pool. We have three restaurants. One is Saffron All Day Dining restaurant. Then we have Mosaic, our Latin American restaurant. And we have Azure Beach Club, offers Asian flavors at the resort. We've started last year with our welcome center. So what that means is that guests arriving from the airport in Katiklan, they will be directly shuttled to our welcome center and don't have to go through the normal port. From there, we have our private speedboats bringing the guests directly to the beachfront. So it's a really exclusive and unique arrival experience, and the same obviously for the departure as well. Om Spa offers a lot of treatments that you would see in traditional spas as well, such as hot stone massage, Swedish massage. What's unique for us is we have a common area for everyone to relax. Our residence artist is Chovinda Maquesta. He works with threads and nails and wood boards, but he does also paintings.
This art room is part of the indoor activities, so I can teach them painting while they're around. I wanted to look like a gallery. That's why there's a variety of artworks that you can see, different techniques of artworks and different style. So when the guests get inside the art room, they can feel the gallery. But I have a solo show at the events pavilion entitled Slices of Life. It describes the daily life that I encountered. So it's all thread and nails. It's a different kind of medium.
Art Warrior is something that's been very close to my heart already since I moved here. So Art Warrior is a live painting competition. So we have 12 artists competing head to head, live in front of an audience. They have only 20 minutes to paint, come up with an art piece. We'll be doing this for the first time and then every second month. And the winner will go into the grand final in December to determine who is going to be the Art Warrior of the year. The artworks that is being produced or created during the actual event will be up for a silent auction, and 50% of the income will go to the actual artist, and 50% will be put back to a program that we call Arts in Youth. For the art pieces will actually be also a vote for the personality of the artist itself. So an art warrior is really someone who puts himself out and is brave, and that's something that maybe have never done before, because 20 minutes goes by very quickly, right? Especially for artists who used to maybe spend days on their artwork. So again, we hope that brings out, you know, makes them more confident and brings out parts of their personality that maybe not even known that they're having.
First Art Warrior Philippines 2023, Shabs Abil.
Sa ganitong competition na Art Warrior, talaga na on the spot, is the first time na sumali ako. Ibig sabihin, painting ko na to is bilang alagad ng sine, kami ang boses ng kalikasan. Dito namin na ipapakita kung ano yung lagay ng ating kalikasan. Meron tayong damdamin dapat para sa ating kapaligiran. Marunong tayong mag-ingat, kapat. Nagsusumigaw ang aking damdamin dito sa art na to. Yung pagtingin ko, bilang pintura eh. Saan ba nanggaling to? Kung sa nature. So, dun ko binigyan ng inspirasyon bawat pahina.
I would like to invite everyone to visit Crimson Boracay. It is really an amazing place. I can promise you, you won't regret it. Our team is ready to serve you. Our facilities are world class, and we hope to see you soon.
This year is our 30th anniversary, so we decided to kicking it off with a more of a traditional event that over the last few years, and we're very happy to sort of have that event, a Reservation in Paradise, this year here in Mactan. So that's kind of the first celebratory event to kick off the birthday celebration. It's really a resort that works well for everybody. If you have families with kids, this is a great place to be. If you're more of a sports enthusiast, opportunities here, we've got a great gym, diving off the coast, which is right here. We've got a golf course in the resort. So there's a lot to do for really everybody. Reservations in Paradise is a great event that has been organized on an almost yearly basis. It's an event that normally revolves around culinary experiences, matching it with wines, but at the same time giving our guests that are here for that event an opportunity to come and relax, just escape from their busy daily lives, and just come here and have a good time at the resort. This year we tried it for the first time in Cebu. It's an event that goes over 3 days really, and we're trying to get different experiences to our guests, different venues, different locations. It's basically a celebration of food and wine, but also we try to really incorporate more of an Asian theme into the culinary experience and try and match that with the more traditional wines. And that seems to have worked quite well this year.
First is the wine, see what wine goes with what food, and then from there I have to plan one by one and how to execute it. I want them to remember the taste of bursting flavors of Asian cuisine. So we have all the four flavors like sour, sweet, salty and spicy. And the global brunch, I would say, is more of a compilation of all the chefs around in Shangri-La Mactan. So they do their own specialty based on their own cuisine. Okay, dinner by the chef is something more fine, more classic way of doing a wine dinner, which is a nice exploding flavors from Chinese and Italian cuisine.
It's a gathering of great friends and creating new experiences for all the people that are coming here. They're really special because Louis Jadot, a really very comprehensive Burgundy house. Graham Port is also beautiful. And of course, Chateau Yquem, which is the most fabulous sweet white wine from Bordeaux. So great, they characterize it as a ray of sunshine in a bottle.
It's a presentation of good wines and good food by Shangri-La Resort. The guests are, you know, just a bunch of people who really enjoy food and wine. From different walks of life, from different industries. It's not for business, but it's just people who love and are passionate about food and wine. Any vineyard that comes to Reservations in Paradise is always special, regardless of where they come from.
Burgundy has probably more pairing option because we offer a wide variety of wines that are not specifically too tannic and perhaps not too strong in terms of taste and flavor. The first wine we had was a Bourgogne Chardonnay. It's your first date with Burgundy. Second one we had is a Chablis Premier Cru Fourchaume 2018. Then we had for the first red a Savigny-les-Beaunes Clos des Guettes 2017. And then we finished with the Clos Vougeot 2013.
For brunch, we went with a new range of wines called the Blend Series, Blend number 5, Blend number 12, which we believe are a lighter expression of port, way more interesting, less sweet, lighter, aromatic, which makes it more suitable for this wonderful day outside. So we went for that instead of the more traditional side.
Universal character of this wine. It's a wine that can give emotion to every palate, also for the occasions where you can enjoy a glass of Yquem.
It is my first time, and I think, you know, what's really special is you bring together a mix of wonderful food, incredible people, but this very special wines, but in a really relaxed setting.
Every Reservations in Paradise has been different. This is a little more real in terms of just the attendees partying on their own without much fanfare. The wines on offer from Louis Jadot to Chateau Yquem. Yquem is probably one of my top most respected wineries in the world.
The experience so far has been great. I mean, everyone saw me enjoying last night dancing away. The food prepared by the chefs of Shangri-La Mactan was outstanding. The wine was superb.
We'll also be launching a commemorative gift to celebrate our 30th anniversary, a very special limited edition of dried mangoes, which is obviously very, very well known here in Cebu. And we're partnering with the local artist, Bria Esplanada, who's done fantastic designs around the packaging, the boxes of the dried mangoes. We would like everybody to come and visit us this year. As mentioned, it's going to be a fantastic year of celebrations. Everybody is welcome here, and we really look forward to welcome you all here at Shangri-La Mactan.
First time I met Jose was in 2005 when he came to visit me. And I said, when you get older, one day you can work for me. And I said to him, if ever you want me to come to the Philippines to do something with you, if you ever get a restaurant, let me know. So we spoke about it beginning of last year, and here we are now. My cooking style would be modern French. I use classical combinations, modern techniques, minimalistic presentation, and using the best ingredients available in the season. Cooking alongside Jose is really good because himself and his whole team are very young, very enthusiastic, and very passionate about food. The 14-course menu we're doing is basically showcasing a lot of seafood from local region. However, I've been very fortunate to get some amazing fish. The menu, I asked Jose what he wants me to showcase. He selected most of the menu from my latest cookbook, and then we developed it to go with Filipino fish, Filipino duck, local chicken, and develop the menu around that.
The event is a two-night collaborative 14-course dinner with my mentor, Chef Donovan Cook from Melbourne, Australia. He's always been the one to inspire me to pursue the culinary career, and it's been a great honor to have him here and showcase his dishes here in Manila. I've known him for more than 10 years. Ever since then, he's been continuously showing me what the life of being in the kitchen industry is like, how hard it is, but also like how much you can express through the craft. Showcase of some of Chef Donovan's dishes. This is one of the first times he's done an event here, and it's been great for us as well because this is a way of teaching us everything about the restaurant, and not just the food but also the menu expresses this. It's very simple, but also it showcases Filipino ingredients done in a way of his style of European and French cooking. Definitely, most of the dishes are sourced from Filipino ingredients from across the country. And these are the basis for the dishes. They have the flavors of European or French or Australian cuisine. They showcase the range of produce that we have here in the country. I didn't think about being a chef at first, but then slowly over time, I was thinking about how this is a food is a great way to express creativity. A lot of the menu of AMAH is stuff that I grew up eating or stuff that I really like to eat. The way that we make it or the way that we serve it is the way that we would like to eat it. It's sort of like sharing what friends and I would like to eat with each other, and hoping that everyone can appreciate it, and hoping that everyone feels at home here and feels welcome to enjoy our food.
We
We would be more than happy to welcome you in the restaurant. We have a lot of food and a lot of ideas to share, and we hope that even if it's a little off the beaten path, I hope to see you dine in the restaurant one day.